Good Friday evening, everyone. Hope everyone's having a good Friday. Jewel here with the J7409 Tropical Update. Thanks so much for joining me. I appreciate it. Got a lot to talk about. I'll try not to make this too long, but taking a look at the GOES East Band 13. Here's disturbance number one. It's still not forming. It's disorganized thunderstorms. I think it's just going to go right on over in this area and then over into Mexico and dissipate. That's what's going to happen. I don't think it's going to turn into a tropical storm. There is one little bump that looks like it could form a tropical depression, but I'm still just a little bit leery of that. It might happen, it might not. But we have disturbance number two. All eyes are on Invest 95L. Folks, you guys in the island areas, get right. Even maybe southern tips of Jamaica, Dominican Republic, you'll get a little bit of something out of this system. And Jamaica, you might get something out of this system. Now, so far as Trinidad and Tobago go, I did not say you wouldn't get anything out of it. It looked like you might not. But what you are going to get for sure is some action out of this tropical wave. Down in your area, it's going to bring you a little bit of wind, not a lot, and a little bit of rain. But 95L is forming now. Look, it's going to be a high-end tropical storm with hurricane strength gust, if not a full-fledged hurricane. It slowed up a bit. We're going to have to watch it. And over here, this is disturbance number three. It's too far out to really tell anything about it as of right now. But back to 95L. Right now, the sustained winds are 35 miles per hour. So it's already a tropical depression. We'll go over to the National Hurricane Center. They probably haven't updated it yet, but it already is. With wind gusts of 46 miles per hour, the barometric pressure is 29.74. And right about now, it's around 1,422 miles east southeast of Bridgeton, Barbados. Now, the coordinates is 8.9 north, 39.1 west. What I'm thinking, it's going to go right over in this area. It could bounce anywhere. So, Trinidad and Tobago and you little islands right down in here, you make sure that you're prepared. Whether you get a lot of this storm or not, because you know how they can change on a dime. And I'm going to tell the entire island chain up to here, please be ready and be prepared. Southern Puerto Rico, you might get the fringe of it, Southern Dominican Republic, and also some of Jamaica could get some of it. Taking a look at the water loop, you can tell that disturbance number one's got lots of rain in it. Yep, you guys over here are going to get lots of rain, but it's not organized. There's no vorticity in it. There's no circular symmetric form to it at all. It's just scattered, disorganized thunderstorms. This is the tropical wave that's going to bring the islands down, Tobago, Trinidad, use some rain right in this area here. You can see how much, but you can see. Look at this start to spin around. You can see it starts to spin around organized. This is disturbance number two, which will affect down in these areas. And the rain over here is very disorganized for disturbance number three, but we're going to have to watch it because, look, I want to tell you guys something. After the 4th of July, it looks like something may develop off the coast of South Carolina and move through North Carolina. I'm not saying that's going to happen. It's too far out. You know how these different models work. Some show them too early, some show them too late, some show them and agree. So I'm not going to say anything's going to happen, but I'm going to say I'm sure going to watch it because there's a possibility. Right quick, let's check in with the National Hurricane Center's latest update. And here we go with disturbance number one in the Western Caribbean, southwestern Gulf of Mexico. This is Invest 90 L94. Now, low area of low pressure over the Western Caribbean Sea associated with a tropical wave, continues to produce widespread shower and thunderstorm activity, as we've just seen from the satellite. Now, the development of this disturbance is not expected today while it moves west-northwest around 10 to 15 miles per hour. The disturbance is forecast to move westward over the Yucatan Peninsula and emerge over the Bay of Campeche late Saturday or early Sunday, at which point some development will be possible. Regardless of development, heavy rain associated with the tropical wave will affect portions of Central America and Mexico through the weekend. And it's got a 30% chance to form, and that's a low chance of forming. Now, over here, two, disturbance number two. This is Invest 95, a low-pressure system located about 1,400 miles east, southeast of the Windward Islands. Let's see, I said it was around 1,422, so I wasn't too different from the National Hurricane Center. It looks like that's how far it is from the Windward Islands. It is becoming better defined, as we could see. It's got a getting a circular motion forming on up, and the associated shower and thunderstorms are increasing in organization, which a satellite picture just showed you also. Now, if these trends continue, a tropical depression will likely form later today. I think it probably already is forming right now. This system is expected to move westward at 15 to 20 miles per hour and approach the Windward Islands by the end of the weekend. And look at this. For those of you who follow me, I told you this in this morning's forecast. Looking like hurricane or tropical storm watches could be required for portions of the region tonight or early Saturday. So everybody in the island area, next time, you're probably going to have some watches and warnings. It's got a 100% chance of forming 2 days and 7 days. Folks, it's going to form and be a high-end tropical storm at some point with hurricane wind gust. Now, we've got disturbance number three. This is a tropical wave. We saw it, and it's several hundred miles south-southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands. Now, it's got disorganized showers in it and thunderstorms, and a little bit of slow development of this system is possible next week. We're going to have to watch it. It's going to move generally westward, just like disturbance number two, at 15 to 20 miles per hour across the central and western tropical Atlantic. It's not going to do anything in 2 days. 7 days is low at 30%. Okay, here is disturbance number two, and I've got this now. The TBCN model is tracking it. You see what the track is looking like going just around this way here, St. Lucia, Barbados, south of here. Then we have Grenada, Trinidad, Tobago, all those. Look, all you guys can feel something from this storm looking like it's going to go over here. Remember I told you some southern sections of Puerto Rico, some southern sections of the Dominican Republic, and some sections of Jamaica will probably feel something out of this storm, whether it's a little or whether it's a lot. But I want to just show you this track from the TVCN model. Now, the National Hurricane Center said that you guys down in these island areas will start feeling it probably by Sunday. Well, you might start feeling a little wind come in by Sunday, but it's still, according to the Euro model, still going to be off track. But Monday, it should come across. Looking like Monday, it should come across. We'll get this to go over to 11 a.m. Monday. You can see right now, hear it here. Let's blow this up some, if we can get it to blow up. And you will see it's going to go over, looking like the center will be just below Bridgeton. But Bridgeton, you're going to get some of it. Bridgetown, okay? And Kingstown, you're going to get some. Also, St. Lucia's going to get some. St. John's going to feel some wind. Shouldn't be too bad, maybe 45 mph gust there, but down in this area here, let's see what the wind gust is going to look like by Monday morning. 63 mph, that's almost hurricane strength. The wind doesn't look bad in Trinidad and Tobago, but this is only the Euro model. It can bounce around. It can change. Everybody be on the outlook. It just might be coming your way. Now, I'll put this over like this. This is Monday around 11 a.m. When it gets back out in the water, let's get up to Tuesday morning. If it'll crop over there, you can see it is going to intensify. Let's see what these winds are looking like. Hurricane strength wind gust. Hurricane strength wind gust. Now, the sustained winds, I'm not going to click this and click that and take up any more time, but it will be a high-end tropical storm with hurricane wind gust. You can see some of this wind will affect Margaret right on over into parts of Puerto Rico and start feeling some down here. And it should move. Let's get it over to midnight Wednesday. Midnight Wednesday. You can see a little bit of southern Dominican Republic. You're going to start getting a little bit of winds. Not going to be anything you can't handle until you move up, say, maybe 12 p.m. lunchtime Wednesday. It should be right around getting just a few miles away from Jamaica at this point. Let's see. It looks like it's dying down a little bit. Hurricane winds, gust of 85 miles an hour. And you can see we got something else coming in the very same direction over here. I think that this will come over around Belize later in the week, but I don't want to go this far right now. I showed you everything I need to show you on this. But I do want to show you what the GFS is forecasting the week after the 4th of July. Now, this is Monday, the 8th of July. You can see right off the coast of South Carolina, just a few isobars. Looks like a low is beginning to form at this point. Now, when we move it on across, you can see it is coming up North Carolina, a few more isobars in. It looks like right now, it's not going to be too bad at all, but it looks like it could form, but then it's going to dissipate. It's too far out to tell whether it will form or whether it will dissipate, to tell you the truth. It's just too far out, so we're going to have to keep our eyes on it and watch it also. Okay, do not fret, Gulf Coast states, disturbance number one. I don't think it's going to bother you too much at all. There is some rain going on, tropical moisture, that some of the Gulf states are receiving at this time, but it's not from this system. Now, all of the island areas, be ready for whatever may change. This thing could turn into, I'm not saying it's going to, but it could turn into a hurricane before it gets to you. More than likely, I'm pretty sure it's going to be a high-end tropical storm with hurricane wind gusts. That's the way everything is looking right now. And so far as disturbance number three, we're just going to have to wait and see what happens with it, just like we're going to have to wait and see what happens with that little low that forms off the South Carolina coast later on in next month. So take care of yourselves. Please be ready. Please be prepared. I love you guys. I thank you for everything you do for me. Your donations, watching, sharing this to help me keep people safe and aware. Don't forget, if you're in any of these areas, to check on the elderly, the handicapped. Help people out. Help your neighbors out. And make sure you've got everything you need before this gets here. I love you. Peace, love, and kindness to all, and thanks for watching.